privileged to have the chief guest of the session, Professor Mushtaq Ahmed I. Patel, Professor, Director of Distance Education, Maulana Azad National Urdu University, Hyderabad. He was served as former principal CTE Bhopal. He rendered his service as registrar, Central University of Karnataka, and he has vast experience and expertise. And because of short of time, apologize for you, sir. Your esteemed presence has indeed glorified the event and added a vibrancy to our intellectual gathering. May I now request Professor Mushtaq Ahmed Patel, sir, to deliver the presidential address. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Assalamu alaikum. Adab to everybody. Professor Naushad Sahab, Professor Rahim, Professor Ahsan Sahab, Professor Sajid Jamal, Dr. Talmeez, Fatma Madam, all our colleagues. It's a pleasure to interact with you on today while discussing about thinking globally and acting locally. To all my presenters in this panel, rehbar bhi ye hamdam bhi ye ghamkhwar hamare, rehbar bhi ye hamdam bhi ye ghamkhwar hamare, ustad ye qaumon ke hain mehmaan hamare. And it's a great time to listen. I'm giving a concluding remark and a presidential address of this. Professor Faiz Ahmed spoke about different aspects of NEP, and he amalgamated various old policies and compared it with National Education Policy 2020. And he showed a ray of hope that HECI will be having teacher education aspect also. And he emphasized on increasing the expenditure of on education. That's a good suggestion. We have been constantly telling about it since Kothari Commission. Even it has been narrated in National Education Policy 2020, but it is not materialized. Professor Sadaqat Ali Khan emphasized that welfare of human being is important. There are issues of dropout, change of place is also affecting. Free education is being offered in countries like Qatar. India has to emulate them. That's a good suggestion. Dr. Kaushal Sharma emphasized on holistic education. Enrollment of children is being emphasized in present policy, but how we are going to provide education without teacher training is the important aspect he has highlighted as to think about. We have to think about that. Dr. Bilal Rafiq Shah emphasized that we have to think about ourselves and help others. He discussed thoroughly about National Education Policy. Our role as teachers, he emphasized that it is important. He also narrated that the government is also aware of important role of teachers in community building or societal upliftment. Dr. Khan Shahnaz Bano highlighted that destiny of India is being shaped in the classroom. A mindful journey, she talked about from zero to infinity. While narrating this, she said that she gave a mantra of being mindful. Being mindful in the technological era, when we are captured by the technology, is an important aspect to be discussed. Dr. Samir Babu informed that professional development of teacher education has to be taken care of. Quality of engagement of teacher has to be looked into. Technological platforms have to be used properly. Madan Mohan Malviya centers are open for professional development, but there are issues of leave or permissions also, he emphasized. When I look at the topic, think global and act local, what I see is we are talking about global village, the world being global village. We are at one point, we are saying it is a village. Village means everybody knows each other, each other's family. They share ideas, thoughts, which we are doing through our social media like Facebook, Twitter, etc. Today, this is an occasion that my family, which is at Bhopal, I am connected using through this media. We get connected, we try to know each other. When I look at teacher education, in olden days, the senior most student used to be teacher. The same system is still followed in madrasa system. A day before, I was interacting with some aspirants of posts, various posts in Manu. Then I came to know that still madrasa practice senior most person being teacher of the young one. Teacher education is not being emphasized. We are talking about prior to education, and national education policy is talking about professional education. So now we have to look into that. Then when we are talking about globalized world means we are at one place, we have to think about our nation, our people. At the same time, we have to think globally. That is why what is happening at Ukraine, what is happening at Afghanistan, what is happening at Palestine is directly or indirectly going to affect us. So that is why Rahat Indoriya said, Lagegi aag to aayenge ghar kai zad mein. Lagegi aag to aayenge ghar kai zad mein. Yahan ye sirf hamara makan thodi hi hai. So in the globalized world, We need to understand global citizen education. We have to provide to our teachers also, because teachers are the persons who are going to go into the field. Comparative education has to be given. Multicultural education has to be given, because international campuses are being opened across India also. UGC has also issued a circular regarding this. See, the climatic changes, global warming, etc. are the issues which are not to be thought by Western country alone. We have to think about it, because when we are talking about sustainable development, then we are part of the globalized village where we have to think that global warming is going to affect our climate. So that is how I see that we have to think globally and act locally without taking much time. I understand the constraint of time. I had plenty of things to be discussed. I thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity. I had a pleasant stay at Bhopal. I remember you all, and I thank the organizer for remembering me in today's program. Thank you.
For addressing and sharing his valuable insight. Your words were a cascade of wisdom and overcasting with inspiration. Thank you, sir, for investing your precious time to enrich your gathering.